which really couldn't care less about jobs. And when the industry fell on tough times after the 1980s, before the resurgence at the end of the 90s, thousands of jobs went to the wall, and nobody in the coal industry or in government did anything about those workers' jobs. It is to be noted, by the way, that while the industry does support some 28 to 30,000 direct jobs in Australia, the Great Barrier Reef, which is threatened with death, the scientists tell us, by mid-century, that's 40 years from now, supports 63,000 jobs. And they're not jobs dependent on the 20, 30 year maximum lifetime of a coal mine. They're jobs that will be there forever and growing into the future if we look after the natural domain, which is so important to the economy. And what does the coal industry offer the economy? Well, according to Sir Nicholas Stern, the World Bank's chief economist, if we keep going the direction we're going and the coal industry wants us to go, then the impact on our grandchildren is going, and their economy is going to be enormous. Forget about the mass extinctions and all the rest of it, the impact on the environment. He calculated that if we take a 1% cut in our gross domestic product now, we'll be able to turn around climate change by mid-century. So we don't go beyond the 2 degrees centigrade warming, which climatologists and scientists estimate is going beyond the danger zone into cataclysm. They don't know if it'll be less than that. They do say go beyond.